Kia ora guys, I'm Mackenzie.
Kia ora, I'm Kia.
And this is Study Time's Level 3 strategy video for plants and animal responses. So a little bit about this standard, it's all about how organisms grow, move, survive and coexist with each other. And some of the key ideas within this standard is the relationships between species and within the species, biological rhythms and movements and growth responses.
This topic has a lot of content to be covered, so it might be hard to know what to prioritise when you're studying. In this video, we'll walk through some common questions and as well as some strategies for success. Let's get into it. Absolutely everything in this paper comes back to a survival advantage. That said, keep in mind that most responses have a disadvantage as well as a positive. For example, an animal that puts in lots of energy into their offspring is advantaged because their offspring is more likely to survive. But they are also disadvantaged because of the survival costs. Round off your answer with an explanation as to why the positives outweigh the negatives, which is why the organism has developed that response.
In answering your question, you should be specific about how these survival advantages arise. And quite commonly, these come about by increasing genetic diversity, like having pollinators for trees, getting energy or nutrients, like plants moving towards the sun, decreasing competition for resources by killing others, gaining protection from predators, such as moving in groups, exploiting new resources others can't, like plants using the sun and animals eating meat, and saving energy, such as hibernation, guaranteed mate selection, such as mating for life, and passing on as many of your genes as possible. And this can be seen in polyamorous species, such as seals that have harems and colonies.
A part of this topic that people seem to have trouble with is actigrams. Make sure to brush up on how to find a free running period from an actigram. This might seem tricky, but it's really just figuring out how much earlier or how much later an activity starts each day.
Another tricky topic within the standard is photoperiodism and the two different phytochromes that control it. So it's important to bear in mind that plants flower at different times of year, depending on how long the days are. And this is controlled by the two different types of phytochromes. So what happens during the day is the plant catches the red light and it's absorbed as far red light. Now during the night time, this far red light is slowly and gradually turned into just red phytochrome. Now it's important to bear in mind that the flowering of these plants is actually controlled by the length of nights as opposed to the days. So if you have a long night, what this means is that you'll have more red because more of that far red could have been turned into the red. And this is how plants know what time of the year to flower.
Diagrams are a really useful tool to make your answers more effective. You'll want to be confident in drawing a diagram to explain how plant growth responses are controlled by auxins, rather than explaining them, which is a lot easier to draw it rather than writing them out in words. There's also heaps of vocabulary that might be hard to memorize, and while there's no easy shortcut, there are some tricks you can use to make memorization a bit easier, such as knowing the difference between taxis and kinesis. If you think about yourself going into a taxi and telling the driver where to go, you'll remember that taxis is a directional response. To remember what nastic responses are, think about touching a plant and the plant shriveling up and saying, "Ew, nasty." Then you'll remember that nastic responses are plant's fast responses.
So a couple of final tips from us is when you're discussing animal or plant responses, it's important to think about both sides of the response. So say for example, you're discussing an organism that is nocturnal, explain how it is beneficial to them to be active during night and how it benefits them to hide from predators during the day. Also, if you're discussing things like hierarchies, talk about the advantages of both being at the top and at the bottom, and vice versa for any disadvantages. Lastly, try not to talk about any of the responses as though they're human. So, for example, a very common thing to say would be that a plant is growing towards the sunlight. However, it's more accurate to say that it is a survival advantage for the plant to grow towards the sun, as it can get more of the sun to create more energy. And when we discuss things like this, what we're doing is we're separating it from being a very like sentient thinking process. So guys, this has been Study Time's Level 3 strategy video for plants and animal responses.
In general, your answer should follow the basic structure. So first, name and define your response from the resource material. Secondly, explain why this response came about first in general and then relate it to your material. List the pros and cons of the response and sum it up by describing how the benefits outweigh the costs.
Cool, so we've covered a lot in this video, but we haven't quite covered everything. We highly recommend that you guys practice a few years worth of past exam papers so you get an idea of the format and the kinds of questions that are going to be asked. And for more content, check out our Study Time walkthrough guides, which are available for free online, or you can buy them in print with next day delivery. Thanks for watching, guys, and good luck.